Earlier today, a major eruption occurred at Indonesia's Semeru Volcano, and for once, many news articles are actually incorrectly understating the severity and extent of what occurred, probably due to a lack of information. What happened is a series of superheated pyroclastic flows with temperatures upwards of 500 degrees Celsius swept down Semeru's main drainage in front of its active crater, incinerating vegetation along the way, and reaching up to 17 kilometers or 10.6 miles downslope. While pyroclastic flows largely remain confined to low-lying areas such as drainages, the less dense and more gas-rich portion of them, known as pyroclastic surges, are able to rise above the flows and occasionally climb otherwise insurmountable topographic barriers. As a result, when pyroclastic flows swept underneath the Glanak-Perak Bridge, 13.9 kilometers downslope of Semeru's summit, the flat topography there allowed for pyroclastic surge gases to rapidly rise and actually then strike the bridge, which had people on it at the time. Although there have not yet been any confirmed fatalities, injuries, specifically from burns, did occur to people both on and near the bridge, which are now being treated. This eruption may have caused damage to additional structures as purported by social media, but I have to label those claims as unconfirmed as some people could theoretically be unknowingly reposting old damage footage from its more deadly 2021 eruption. It is tough on my end to tell the difference. Regardless, ashfall was reported in communities to the south and southwest, and the associated eruption plume rose to an altitude of 59,000 feet or 18 kilometers. As a result, commercial aircraft are rightfully avoiding the area where the eruption plume is drifting in and towards for the time being, but at least so far, there do not appear to be any flight cancellations. For more specifics regarding the timeline of today's eruption, it involves seven separate explosions which each generated multi-kilometer-long pyroclastic flows, although only one of these reached the full 17 kilometers distant. The first explosion occurred at 2:13 p.m. local time, generating a 5-kilometer-long pyroclastic flow. Over the next 2.5 hours, four more explosions occurred, which each generated longer and longer pyroclastic flows until the largest explosion occurred around 4:50 p.m. This generated the 17-kilometer-long pyroclastic flows and surges, which not only impacted the bridge, but seemingly spilled over the sides of the river channel in some spots, likely incinerating an area of several square kilometers. Another smaller explosion thereafter occurred, and then the eruption seemingly stopped at 6:11 p.m. It likely will be a few days until we know for sure exactly what spots were impacted. So, why did today's eruption occur? Simply put, a similar reason to the deadly eruption of Guatemala's Fuego volcano in 2018. During the last 3 years, both the summit lava dome and volumes of hot tephra generated alongside it piled up to increasing depths near the active crater. Due to the thick volume of present lava, this mass would take multiple years, possibly even a decade or more to cool, and this doesn't even account for the fact that Semeru was still erupting and new material is still being added every week. As a result, the tephra eventually reached an unstable threshold, and all it would take was a trigger for parts of it to collapse and give way to lengthy pyroclastic flows. It is unclear whether that trigger was the heavy rainfall Semeru experienced today, the force of multiple larger-than-typical explosions, or a combination of both. Regardless, it is quite likely in my opinion that its summit lava dome was partially destroyed and the ravine leading out of it is likely now deeper. Semeru's alert level was raised to red, its highest level, and there is still the potential for additional pyroclastic flows to occur. The good news is that many areas seemingly reached by today's pyroclastic flows and surges were abandoned after the destructive 2021 eruption hit some of those areas, thus reducing the number of potential casualties. Stay tuned for more updates. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube for supporting my work.